Hello students, in this class of ours we are going to study so as to what the mirror formula is. Mirror formula for the spherical mirrors, particularly now we are studying, so you can say the mirror formula is the formula which is able to establish relationship between the focal length and the image distance and the object distance in case of let us say spherical mirrors in this particular case. So the formula is like this: 1 upon f is equal to 1 upon focal length is equal to 1 upon image distance, and this is object distance u. And let me tell you very clearly that both image distance, this is pole, image distance and object distance are always measured from pole of the mirror. Pole is the midpoint of the actual reflecting surface. Let us say this is actual reflecting surface and this is the midpoint, so this is pole. U is also measured from pole, V is also measured from pole. V is image distance and U is object distance. F is the focal length. In case of a concave mirror, you can see here the principal focus is this. The definition of the principal focus in case of a concave mirror is like this, that all the light rays, the principal focus is a point on the principal axis to which all the light rays which were initially parallel, that is before reflection, parallel and close by to the principal axis are converged to. So this being principal focus, distance between principal focus and pole is the focal length, and any, as per sign conventions we have seen in the previous video, that this, any point which is lying in a direction opposite to the direction of the incident ray from the object or lying to the left of the pole will be assigned a negative sign. So the focal length of a concave mirror will always be taken negative. And another thing that I want to make here amply clear is that in case this is a real focus, this is a real focus, though this is not very much concerned here, but yet let me tell you, this is a real focus because light rays are actually meeting here, and here this is called virtual focus because light rays do not actually meet after reflection there. They appear to diverge, they appear to diverge, and in fact they are not even diverging from that point, they just appear to diverge. Principal focus of a convex mirror is a point on the principal axis from which, now it is not to which, from which all the light rays which were initially parallel and close by to the principal axis, that is before reflection they were parallel and close by to the principal axis, appear to diverge after reflection. So this is the principal focus, and distance between pole and principal focus is the focal length. This is lying in the same direction in which the incident ray is moving from the object, because the object is always kept to the left of it, so it will move in this direction. This is lying in this direction. Another way of telling the same thing is that this is lying to the right side of the pole of the mirror, so this distance will be assigned a positive sign, and this is a virtual focus, this is a real focus. Object is always kept to the left of it and above the principal axis, to the left of pole and above the principal axis. So height of the object will always be taken positive and the distance will always be taken negative. Distance, so object distance is negative, object height is always positive. And in case of concave mirror, images are found this side also, that they are real and inverted, and also in one case when the object is between pole and focus, virtual and direct image is formed behind the mirror. For this, distance will be positive, image distance will be positive, also height of image will be positive. But all the images which are real and inverted and formed in front of the concave mirror or to the left side of the pole, the height will also be negative and the distances of such images also will be negative. So this is more than enough at this point of time so as to what the mirror formula is. This will give us when different things are, informations are given to us.